you all are doing good. In today's class, we are again going to continue with the lesson, the heavenly parasol. So in the last class, Meghavahana got married to Amrita Prabha. Later when he was going to seek blessings from her father, the king, so that time a heavenly parasol, the parasol of Varuna, cast the shadow on Meghavahana. And later, when he came back with his bride and the parasol to his kingdom, over there, the minister of Kashmir, he said that he wants to make Meghavahana as the king, okay, as the king of Kashmir. So, Meghavahana also became the king of Kashmir and he proclaimed the law, okay, he proclaimed the law that no human being should be killed or harmed. And later he went on a voyage, okay, near the sea he went on a journey, on an expedition, and over there when he was planning to conquer Lanka in the woods, okay, the nearby woods, he heard a loud cry of a man, okay. So hearing that noise, Meghavahana ran into the woods and he saw that a barbarian was holding a cruel man, okay, a barbarian was standing beside a man who is laying there on mercy, okay, and he was brandishing, the barbarian was making his sword sharp. So later what happened we will see in today's class. Stop, cried the king, shocked at the sight. So Meghavahana said stop, so he was very shocked at the sight what he was seeing. You wretch, you dare threaten another life in my realm. So the king said, you wretch means you unhappy person. How dare you to threaten? How dare you can kill other human being in my realm? Realm means kingdom. So he's asking, how dare you can kill another human being, that too in my kingdom? The barbarian dropped his sword in terror. So the barbarian, he was holding his sword, right? So he just dropped the sword in terror. He was very frightened and he fell on his knees before the king. So on his knees, he fell before the king. Oh noble one, have mercy. I am the leader of a troop of barbarians that live in this wood. So he says that, please have mercy on me, noble one. So he is the king. So he is just with respect, he says that, noble one, please have mercy on me. I am the leader. Okay, here the barbarian was a leader of a barbarian troop and he lived in this woods. My little son has fallen prey to some disease and is on his deathbed. So the barbarian's little son is suffering from some kind of disease and he is on his deathbed. If I kill this man, the gods will be pleased and save my son's life. So barbarian says that, if I kill this man, the gods will be pleased and they will also make my son normal. If you prevent this sacrifice, my son dies and the rest of my troop will give up their lives with him. So he says that, if this sacrifice happens, if this man will die today, my son will be alright. Okay? If you are giving a negative opinion on this sacrifice, if you are telling no to this sacrifice, then my son will die. Okay? If you are not willing to accept this sacrifice, then my son will die and the rest of the men in my troop also will die with him. So this was the barbarian. He pleaded the king. This was the way barbarian pleaded the king. So he says that, please noble one, please let me do this, because this sacrifice is very important, because my son is suffering from some kind of disease, and if I do this sacrifice, the gods will be pleased, the gods will be happy and they will become, they will make my son back to normal. If you are not accepting this sacrifice to be done, then my son will die and the rest of the men in my troops also will dialysis. The king glanced towards a bundle on the temple porch and presumed it to be the sacrificed boy. His heart was torn with confusion and compassion. So what did the king do? He quickly glanced, okay? Glanced means he gave a hurried look towards a bundle of temple porch. Okay, so the covered shelter, you know, the tall shed, the shelter of the temple. So he just gave a hurried look and presumed means believe something. Okay, presumed means believe something. And he presumed that it is the sacrifice dead for the boy. He believed what the barbarian said. His heart was torn with confusion and compassion. Okay, so the king, after hearing this, and later he believed, okay, after seeing, after giving a glance to the temple porch, he just presumed, he just believed what the barbarian said. Now the king is confused what to do, okay, and he is also in compassion. Compassion means he is feeling pity, okay, he is feeling pity for the little boy who is in disease, as well as a man who is going to be a victim for the sacrifice. So he was filled with pity. This man whom you desire to protect, continued the barbarian. So now again the barbarian is continuing. This man whom you desire to protect was wandering about alone and friendless in the forest. So the barbarian said, the man whom you are thinking to protect was alone. He was alone and he was just wandering. He was roaming around friendless. He had nobody. He was just wandering around the forest. Is he of more value to you than this child with whom many persons are connected? So he's asking, is this man who is alone, who doesn't have any friends or who doesn't have any people with him, is he more important to you than this little child who has many people connected to him? So these are the words that the barbarian asked. The victim sat crying on the ground, a look of terror on his face. So after hearing this, he was the victim, okay, the man who was going to be sacrificed, he started to cry. Okay, he was frightened and he started to cry. He was thinking that they are going to kill me. So he started to cry. Tears fell from the barbarian's eyes. So even the barbarian also was crying. Even his eyes was filled with tears. Sir, tell me what to do, he cried. I cannot see my son suffer this way. So the barbarian is telling, tell me what to do now. I don't know what to do. Tell me what to do. I cannot see my child suffering like this. The king spoke firmly. So the king, with a voice of order, he spoke very firmly. Do not be distressed. Okay, do not be distressed. Distress means do not be in pain or sorrow. Distress means pain or sorrow. I will save your son as well as this victim. So the king said, I will save your son as well as the victim here. I offer my body in sacrifice to Chandika. So he says, I will sacrifice myself. You kill me. I will sacrifice myself to the goddess Chandika. Kill me, O barbarian. May these two persons live. So you kill me, barbarian. You just kill me. If I die, at least these two people will live. So you can sacrifice my body to the goddess Chandika. So this is what Meghavahana said. The barbarian, struggling between incredulity and fear, took a step backwards. So the barbarian, he was confused already, and he was not willing to kill the king. Okay, incredulity means being unwilling. Okay, incredulity means being unwilling. Now he was not willing to kill the king. Okay, so he took a step backward. Sir, you are the king. So the barbarian said, sir, you are the king. Your life should be protected at all times. So he said, you are the king and your life is of more importance and it should be protected. Do not pity this victim. Let him die. His life is of no significance. So the barbarian said, you don't have any sympathy towards this victim. Okay, let he die. Okay, let this victim only die. You don't sacrifice your life. You are a king. Okay, you should be protected. I will kill this victim only because his life has no significance, because his life is of no importance. The king shook his head impatiently. So Meghavahana shook his head impatiently. Impatiently means in annoyance. He shook his head. If I can use my body to stop a killing, why should I not? So he said, if I am ready to die, if I am ready to die and sacrifice my body to avoid a killing, then why can I not sacrifice my own body? So he asked this question. Do not speak another word, kill me. So Meghavahana said to the barbarian, you don't speak another word, now kill me, he said. The barbarian hung his head and made no move to take his sword. So the barbarian dropped his head down and he did not make any step to take the sword. If you cannot bring yourself to strike at me, I will use my own sword for the purpose. So Meghavahana said, if you cannot do it, if you are not able to strike at me, strike means to hit me with a sword, I will do it with on myself. Okay, I will do it myself with my own sword, he says. So saying, the king drew out his sword. After saying these words, Meghavahana took out his sword. Later what happens? The barbarian and the victim watched in horror. So Meghavahana, he was going to chop his own head. So the barbarian and the victim, they are seeing this in a horror. They were very frightened, they were in fear. As Meghavahana was about to strike himself, his head was covered with divine flowers. So what happened when he was going to hit himself, when he was going to strike himself with the sword, there was divine flowers, okay, there was divine flowers of exquisite color and perfume, okay, there was flavor, the perfume, the smell, it was exquisite, it was extremely beautiful colors and it was of beautiful smell, okay, the perfume from the flowers, the flowers was very divine and it was of exquisite color, extremely beautiful colors, and the smell of the flowers was like a perfume, it was very good fragrance. And someone held back his arms, okay, and someone stopped him from chopping his head off. The king whirled around in surprise and beheld a person of heavenly appearance. So the king, he just whirled means he rapidly took a turn. So he just moved rapidly to see who stopped him. Okay, so he just moved rapidly to see who was that, and there was a person. Okay, there was a person of heavenly appearance. Okay, the person was looking just like he has come directly from heaven. So he had such kind of appearance. Then he realized that the barbarian, the victim, and the ailing boy had vanished. When the heavenly appearance came, the barbarian, the victim, and the ailing boy, okay, the boy who was sick, all they vanished, they all disappeared. So, who was the heavenly appearance and what happened next to Meghavahana? We'll see in the next class, students. Stay safe. Thank you. Bye.